Hello and welcome back to the Bournemouth Heaven History TV. And today we're going to have another look at a exam technique. Okay, today we're going to have a look at interpretation comparisons. Now, an interpretation is somebody's view of something that happened in the past. And in many parts of the exam, you will be asked to look at some interpretations and pass judgment on those interpretations. Today, we're looking at when you are given two interpretations and you have to compare them. Now, generally, this question is split into two parts. Three parts. We're going to look at the first two parts today. The how do the interpretations differ and the why do the interpretations differ. So let's have a look at how we approach those questions. So here's an example. Excuse me. From a previous examination paper, read interpretations A and B in the interpretations booklet. How does interpretation B differ from interpretation A about women in the 1920s? Explain your answer based on what it says in interpretation A and B. So as usual, we look at the question and we break down what it's after. First thing, how? How does the source differ? All right, that is important. We'll talk about that in a second. And what is it that it wants us to look at what it's different about? Women in the 1920s. So there's the focus of our question. And then what are we going to use to answer that? It's what it says in the interpretation itself. Okay. So how do we go about looking at this? It is only 4 marks. So it's not a huge question. It shouldn't be taking you very long, no more than 5 minutes. All right. So what do we do? Firstly, we read the interpretation, both of them. Okay. A and B. Possibly easier to take one at a time. We say, what does it suggest about what it was like for women? Because that's our question. What aspects of women's life are they focused on? What evidence do they use? That's the words they use to back up their interpretation. And we must remember the how question is not about who wrote it and why. Okay? It is not to look at the provenance. It is essentially you are looking at the content of the interpretation. So I've given you here the interpretations that go with that, and I have kept away the provenance so we don't get drawn into that. So interpretation A, it was totally confusing to read the adverts in the magazines that showed vacuum cleaners, fridges, and hundreds of other household devices which should lighten the jobs of women in the home. Women living on farms did a great deal of work besides caring for their children, washing clothes, cooking, as they worked in the fields and looked after the animals. The largest group of American women were families of laborers, miners, steelworkers, and unskilled workers. The wages of the men were generally so small that women had to do extra work. So the question's asking us what the how two interpretations differ, so we've got to understand what the message is in this one. So the message in interpretation A is that women were not benefiting from the boom. Okay, you can see that there. Women of a certain group, farm workers, traditional industry, laborers, unskilled steel workers, coal miners, all of those people were not benefiting from the boom. The vacuum cleaners, the fridges. Notice I'm only using words from the source as well. So what we have here is a focus on how these women had to work to back up their husband's meager wage, as well as what they did in the home. So actually, life was very tough. And these new vacuum cleaners were things were not getting to those women and making life easier. Okay. What about interpretation B? Well, it's going to show you a different view because they want you to say how it's different. So you've probably been able to guess which group of women this is going to be about. Yeah. Flappers. So here we go. It was an age of miracles and an age of overindulgence. There was a generation of women who saw themselves as flappers, the wildest of all generations, deciding to take as much pleasure as they could. Eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow we die, was their motto. Although their grandmothers didn't know it, these young women had discovered alcohol and jazz. Now you can see here, how is this different to the other one? Well, what is the message? This one, So the message for this one is that young women were going out and enjoying themselves. Women were having a great time. They were living each day as if it was their last, despite the fact that the older generation would not like it, okay? Their grandmothers didn't know it. That's not necessarily saying their grandmothers were dead, by the way. They could be alive and not knowing it. So it's saying that, you know, they didn't care what older people thought about them. So that's what we're looking at. So we've looked at the sources. On the whole, what are they saying? So they're saying the first one, interpretation A, is not that women didn't have much of a change and the boom didn't benefit them. Interpretation B is saying that it hugely did. Now let's have a look at two answers and see what we have to say about those, okay? So answer number one is a very basic one or two marks for this question, all right? Interpretation A describes the lives of women who clearly did not benefit from the economic boom. So it's given an overview of the source. Interpretation B describes younger generation, the flapper lifestyle, to the disgust of the older generation of traditionalists. It gives you a general idea that there is a touch at the very end where they're trying to bring in stuff that it actually says in the source, but not enough. So this gets two marks, and you can see they haven't gone very far, but it gets two marks. How do we get into the three and four then? Well, it's essentially making a suggestion about what it's saying on a whole and then finding some information within that to back up what you're saying. So you can see here, interpretation A describes the lives of women who did not benefit from the boom. There's a point, there's the suggestion, there's the overview. The new consumer goods meant little to them as they still had to work hard in the home and traditional roles, but they also had to take on extra work to supplement their husband's low pay. And that is the stuff from the source to say, the source says this, the source is pointing at this to back up that idea, okay? By contrast, interpretation B describes a younger generation of urban women who had the wealth to be able to go against tradition and embrace the flapper lifestyle to the disgust of the older generation of traditionalists. Top marks, all right? That's what that's going to get. And here it is an actual examination response. The examiner says it shows developed analysis. It explains the differences between the interpretation, the contrast between the traditional role and the flappers who threw off tradition. And it has content supporting from both of the interpretations. Right. So what about the next question? Here it is. Why might the authors of interpretation A and B have different interpretations about women in the 1920s? Explain your answer using interpretation A, B, and your contextual knowledge. Now, what's this one asking us to do? Why are they different? Well, there's lots of reasons why people have different views, their way that they were brought up, what they watch on the telly, whereabouts they live at the time, who they interact with at the time, what they want people to get to do. You can have lots of different things for reasons for it, okay? Let's take some tips here, okay? Why might they have different opinions? Well, what you've got to think about, this is all about the provenance of the source. Who made it? Okay, who made the interpretation? Not the source, I do apologize, it's an interpretation. When was it made? Okay. And why are they saying what they're saying? What are they getting out of that in that view that they have? All right. So who made it? When did they make it? How does that affect it, what they're saying? And why are they saying it? Do they want something out of it? Well, if we have a look at the first interpretation, sorry, I keep using the word source. I'm a silly billy. And we look at the provenance. It's from a book written by Doris E. Fleischman, published in 1932. So we know that this is during the bust years. It's after the boom. Can we really make much from that? No, we need a little bit of extra information, and thankfully it comes. So Doris was writing about what life was like for women in the 1920s. She was a famous campaigner for the rights of women. So let's think about this. What is she wanting? If she's a campaigner for women's rights, she wants women to have more rights. So what is she going to focus on to get more rights? She's not going to say, oh, you know, we've got most of our rights already, but it would be nice to have the next 25%, because everyone would be like, oh, what are you whinging about? You've got most of them anyway. She's a campaigner. So how is she going to make things look? What is she going to focus on? She's not lying, but she's only focusing on the negative. Yeah, you talk about your flappers, but they were a tiny percentage. What about the rest of us? All of these women, come on, more rights, more rights. She's campaigning. And as soon as you start campaigning, you are one-sided, you are only focusing on the negative, and you are really pushing to get people to change their minds. All right? What about the interpretation B then? Well, here's the provenance. An article written about flappers by F. Scott Fitzgerald, published in the 1930s. F. Scott Fitzgerald is an author. He's famous for writing about for the Great Gatsby. But we can't say very much about that, can we? So we need a little bit more information. Here it comes. He was a novelist who, both in his personal life and his book, showed what it was like to be a rich playboy during the boom years of the 1920s. He and his wife, Zelda, who became called the first American flapper, became a symbol of jazz age. So let's think about it. Who is F. Scott Fitzgerald going to have spent most of his time around? The flappers. All right. Who does he know most about? The flappers. As far as F. Scott Fitzgerald is aware, what lifestyle did women have? His wife and everyone? The flapper lifestyle. Therefore, he is going to focus on what he knows about the flapper. All right, so let's have a look at some examples here. Interpretation A was by Fleischman, who was a campaigner who would use information about different groups of women to support a case. Interpretation B was a novelist who would have had little knowledge outside of his social circle. Very basic, 2 marks. What about top marks? Here we go. Let's have a look at this. Fleischman was a campaigner for women's rights. So focuses on women who were trapped by poverty and tradition, who did not enjoy the freedoms offered by the economic boom. Fitzgerald, by contrast, was writing about the women he knew. He was wealthy and his wife was a flapper. So he was writing about the lifestyle him and his wife experienced. As a novelist who wrote about the fun life of wealthy women who lived in the cities, he probably knew nothing about the lives of ordinary women that Fleischman was interested in. And you can see there, the examiner tells us, the response shows developed analysis of the provenance for each interpretation. Explanations of reasons for the difference are based on the beliefs of Fleischman and the context in which Fitzgerald was writing. Now, remember, if you're watching this video because it's been set as an interpretation question, you may not have this question, but the same applies for any interpretation question. You will be given 2 interpretations and you'll be asked, how are they different? And you will be asked, why are they different? And these skills are what you will use. Top tips, folks, talk about both sources. You must talk about both sources. How is using the source content? We're using the content. What does it suggest? And then finding information that backs that up. Why is using the provenance? Okay, so hopefully this will help us become heaven history heroes when we are comparing and contrasting interpretations. See you soon.